Hi everyone. Thank you for following along on this channel forever. And I've heard a few comments about updating this one particular section of the crash course, the UV mapping of the beer bottle label specifically. So I'm going to be using C4D 2023 and just walking you through how you would UV map a beer bottle label using the most current version of Cinema right now. And I'll start the video off just by showing you my about page on the inside Cinema so you can see what version I'm actually using. And honestly, it's actually a really easy process this time. They made it very streamlined. It's no longer any like islands of like sections of a cylinder cut up with gaps in between or anything. It's all pretty easily done. So I'll show you that process. The one thing you still have to do is save a texture file as a Photoshop file so you can use it in Photoshop and do all that kind of stuff, which I'll walk through as well. So thank you again for following along, and we'll get started. So here is the About section of my program, so you can see what version I'm using of Cinema. First thing I'm going to do is just create a cylinder primitive and size it to the beer bottle. So what I'm going to do is go to the cap section and just uncheck the caps so there's no top or bottom parts of the cylinder covering it. And so now we're going to have a beer bottle label. I'm just going to extend the amount of segments to be about 72, which I think is the same amount of segments that the beer bottle has. And then just kind of refine the radius of the cylinder. And that should be really good by then. So now we have a beer bottle label as a cylinder on this beer bottle. So now what I'm going to do is duplicate this object so that I have, just as a backup, I have the parametric version of this cylinder. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to hit C to make one of them a polygon object. So I'm hide that, hit C, there we go. Now I have a polygon object of that cylinder. I go to UV edit, which used to be body paint, and you can see automatically it's already been laid out as a UV map. And it's got its own seam, and it's seamless, there's no islands. All of the UVs and the polygon sizes are all proportionate. If I go into the selection tool, I need to select the polygon faces mode, and I can be selecting these polygons right now. And you can see how they all match. Here's the seam right here that was automatically created. So if I select two polygons on both sides of that seam, you can see where the seam actually is. So it's really awesome. Like, this is all done automatically. And it shows you exactly where the seam is. And again, we didn't have to do anything to create that. So now that it's created, and we can tell that it's seamless. Now if I go into the polygon mode, this is the UV mode right here. So I'm selecting UV polygons right now, as opposed to polygons, I guess you could call it. I'm just making sure that there's no seams. There aren't any. So what I'm going to do now is go to File and select New Texture. What that's going to do is we're going to start to create the actual image file that we'll be using for this label. So I name it. 2048 by 2048 is a good size. That's a lot, but it'll look really nice. It's all fine, hit okay. So now we have that. And now we have to actually save that texture as a file. So we go to File, and then Save Texture As. This is how we can set the file format for this texture. Make it a PSD, hit okay. And we save it to where we want to put it, which we'll come back to and open it in Photoshop. So we have that now. Now the next thing I want to do is go to Layer dropdown and select Create UV Mesh Layer. And that's going to be helpful inside Photoshop. You can't really see it right here. But then once we do that, we go back to File and hit Save Texture. Now we go into Photoshop and open that file up, and we're going to apply the beer label graphic to it. So here we are in Photoshop. Now the UV mesh layer is that white grid right there, so it gives you a guide on how, so it gives you a guide on what the UV mesh looks like inside Photoshop. Now for this, we're going to be putting just a beer label on this, so this won't be so useful, but it's really helpful to know how to create one. And there it is. I'm going to scale it up and place it. So I like to always create my textures and then add the UV mesh layer before I save it, before I open it up into Photoshop, so I have that as a reference. So we have that, but I want to get rid of the mesh layer and the background because I want it to be transparent on the edges. I also rasterize this just so it cuts down on problems inside Cinema. So here we have this as a Photoshop file with a transparent background. This is what I want to use on the beer bottle. So let's go back to Cinema. And now instead of placing this file, all we have to really do is go to File right here and do Revert Texture to Saved, because we've saved it in Photoshop. So it's going to call that image and that file up. So it's going to ask you, do you really want to? Hit Yes. Once you do that, it's going to call up the Photoshop file. And so now since we made changes in Photoshop and saved it, it's going to revert to those changes. So that's a really nice little trick to get this updated Photoshop file into Cinema really quickly. But as you can see, it doesn't show up on the label yet because we have to actually be creating a material that uses that Photoshop file as the color channel. So let's make a new material. You can just do a default material. This is inside physical render, not Redshift render. Now I have that default material. Open that up and go to the color channel, hit the texture, and then load that Photoshop file that we created. Close it out. Well, as you look at it, you can see it's too stretched horizontally, but we can fix that in Photoshop. I also want to set the alpha channel inside here so that the transparency reads in the material. So I'm just going to copy the shader from the color channel, go to alpha, and then paste the shader. And now you can see how it cuts out the background of that material, and now it's transparent over the beer bottle, which will be glass. Right now there's actually no material attached to the beer bottle model. Let me hit render, and there we go. It's there, it's got transparency. I'm just going to put the glass material on the bottle, and now you can see, at least in physical render, the label is set with transparency as if it's just been kind of pasted over the glass of the bottle. Now when I go back into Photoshop and just resize this label, I'm actually going to make it smaller and then just kind of squeeze it horizontally because it'll stretch back out as it gets mapped across the bottle. Hit OK. Now we go back into Cinema and we have to go into the material and then in the shader right there and hit Reload Image. Hit Yes. And then there we go. It updates from what we had made changes in Photoshop. And there we go. This looks like a very nice, non-stretched beer label. And it was much more easy to do than previous versions of Cinema. So I hope that you enjoy this. Thank you very much for watching.